Welcome to Get Real with Andy. Today's topic is bullshit. Bullshit shows up wherever and whenever people interact. Bullshit is when you blame someone else for your suffering. Bullshit is when you complain as a way to feel powerful. Bullshit is thinking that circumstances and other people hold the key to your happiness. We absorb bullshit when we're kids in the form of all the unspoken assumptions about who's in charge and who knows what's what, as if someone else knows better than me about me and what I feel and what I need. When mom shushes my tears because she's uncomfortable with them, that's bullshit. When I swallow the idea that there's something wrong with me, that's bullshit. When dad hits me because he's so frustrated, that's bullshit. Bullshit runs deep. It's the deeper veils we shroud our ever-loving joy in, the nets we bind ourselves and others with, the lies we live as if they are reality. A good therapist is not only a good bullshit detector, but also knows how to reach you with an awareness of your own bullshit, while at the same time inspiring you to rise to your true greatness. A good therapist sees through your bullshit, even when you don't. A good therapist won't do your work for you either, but will let you become aware of how bullshit-steeped you've become and will guide you towards the clear, clean water to wash yourself off. Even a diamond dipped in bullshit will stink till it's cleaned. But here's the good news. A diamond entrenched in bullshit for many years is still the diamond. The swan who grew up with ducks thought she was an ugly duck. That's bullshit. Fortunately, she found her true nature and loved it and stayed forever humble for all the years of bullshit duck living. She didn't dwell on blaming the ducks for her own delusional life or her history of low self-esteem, because that would be bullshit squared. She just got on with being a swan. I love that story. Last part of this metaphor. Bullshit is great fertilizer. And shoot, we're planted in it already, so why deny it? We grow out of our history and are not bound in it or by it. That lotus plant has its roots in the muck, but the pure white blossoms never touch the dirty water. It's just the way it is. I'm saying we don't have to fight where we came from. It doesn't have to be where we remain. Thank you.